If you need cheap FIFA coins, make sure you check out buyfifacoins.com. The website's very simple to use and the coins are super cheap. And when you are at checkout, make sure you use code COIL for an extra 5% off your purchase. What is going on YouTube? Welcome back to another video on the channel. So today's video is going to be another player review based on a Prem Team of the Season player, and that is none other than Ilkay Gundogan. We opened our guaranteed Prem player pack and we actually managed to pack him. Bit gutted. The only one I really want from this team of the season is Mason Mount, and we still haven't got him. Hopefully from rewards tomorrow we can pick him up from either our reds or just pack him in general. But let's have a deep dive look into the card now. So with this card, he's got a good height for me as of cam, 5'11". He's not too tall, not too short. He's a nice height. High medium work rates, 4-star, 4-star, perfect for that cam roll. Also, base stats wise, he looks incredible. Maybe be suited as like a more attacking minded centre mid, but we're going to try him in that cam roll just to see how he plays there. We're going to compare him to Mason Mount because obviously we tried him there previously in one of the other reviews. So we'll just see how they compare the two. Stats, in-game stats wise, I mean, the card just looks phenomenal. Short passing and long passing, 97, 94. They are insane stats. We have whacked an engine chem style on him because we just want to boost that the agility, balance, and then the speed a bit more. We've also given those nice boosts to the passing. Shooting stats, again, they look amazing. We got the 96 shot power, the 92 long shots, 88 finishing for a cam is very nice. Player traits, unfortunately, most of them are CPU based, so we don't get to use him. He's only got the injury prone one for us. I do want to try the finesse shot with him because Mason Mount didn't have it, but his finesse shots were insane. Want to see how they play with this card. We got him playing in our standard weekend league squad. The only thing we swapped out here is we normally put Messi in this spot, but we swapped him around, and in game the custom tactics stay the same from previous videos. But this is where everyone sets up. So we've got Aguero and Eto'o up top. We're going to go in the cam. Vieira's our centre mid, CDM. Buendia is our box to box. And Cantona is our attacking centre mid. What we'll do now is we'll get into game number one. And hopefully we can get some good highlights with this Gundogan card. So first opponent of the episode is rocking a 4-5-1. Very nice squad. That is Meili Sarr. I've come up against him numerous times now since that card's been released. And he's incredible. Fingers crossed though, the boys for the mighty J. Coyle Road to Glory account can get the dub here. See how Gundogan plays off the bat. Oh, Ferlamendi doing what he does best. Good hold up play. He's got the ball off as well. If we get a goal here, oh, it's unlucky. Good hold up play from Gundogan there. Managed to evade the tackle and unlucky with the pop shot from Aguero. Though, he's, do you know what, he evades the tackle well, so even though the players are constantly coming into him, he just doesn't get knocked off the ball easy. His agile dribbling's not the best, seems a bit clunky there. Gundogan still got it. Oh, he's knocked that directional nutmeg way too far in front. That's Aguero's fault there. Oh, yeah. So that's one thing he is going to lack there is that pace. So even though he got the directional nutmeg off, he lacked the pace there. Little feint. Oh, he missed the shot. Finishing doesn't feel as clinical as Mason Mount. I will say that. I feel like if Mason was in that position, he would have scored it. Not being biased at all. We saw it from the player review. He was phenomenal in front of goal. One thing that is letting this Gundogan card down is his support he's got up top. Because this Aguero is not helping. He's still got it. Oh, he's got the pop shot off. Yeah, this one thing about this Gundogan, he is solid. Like, he feels strong. He's got the pot shot off. First goal. Lovely. Yeah, when he's in those positions with the defender on him, he does not get knocked off the ball very easy. You'll probably see from the highlights, depending on what gets included, the amount of times that he stands firm, doesn't get knocked off the ball, and luckily he's managed to get a goal there for us. And it's a pretty weird touch. That's a lovely pass from him. Oh my god. I mean, lovely pass from Gundogan there, but Eto with that finish. That was insane. Wow. So, a goal and assist on his debut. I'm liking this card. Maybe not cam-worthy. He might be better suited as that box-to-box, because as I said, he feels very strong. Right. So, we need... If Aguero can make a good run... Aguero's not timed his run. That's just Aguero not timing his run. It was unlucky. Bit better of a run from Aguero. We could have been clean through and he could have got a second assist. But it's half time. 2-0. Good start for him. Yeah, as I said, he may not be a cam. Box to box, probably best suited for him. So where I've got this Cantona currently seeing, that's probably going to be his best role. But we'll try him for the second half of cam. Maybe in the second game, we might try him as a box to box, see how he does there. Oh, Ferland Mendy, stop that. Oh, Paddy V's lost it. Paddy V has lost it. Should be a first goal. And it is. All come from Patrick Vieira's mistake. Lovely goal from Lo Celso. 2-1. This guy could be on the comeback now. It's really a battle of Gundogan versus Hamza Choudhury here. Like, they are just on each other constantly. His goal. It's a goal. Knew it. Couldn't stop it. As Meili Sarr has brought it back to 2-2. Aguero's got to come off. Honestly, one of the worst players I've used this year. He is honestly shocking. It's not even his balls that are causing the issues. It's the poor runs. Have we got? Is that a free kick to us? Or I'm gonna bring Neres on there. Actually, no. We're gonna bring Sarr on ourselves. We'll try that out. I'm not sure if that's a free kick to us or to him. If it's a free kick to him, I have no idea what for. No, right, it is a free kick to us. What's Gundogan's free kicks like? 82 free kick accuracy. We'll test it. Hopefully our free kick method can work it. No, he's got Matt. He's got men just blocking it. Yeah, because he's got poor free kick accuracy, it's hard to get in the spot. Right, fingers crossed. It's rattled the post. It so nearly worked. I thought that was going to be offside because the animation went really weird. Well, at least we got the assist from the rebound from the free kick. I'll take it. 3-2. Didn't mean to go there, but it is what it is. Oh, he's messed up though. Oh, lovely from Gundogan. Honestly, I'm actually impressed by this guy. I didn't think I would be, but he's actually playing pretty decent. Two goals and assists, and obviously the free kick as well that rattled the post, and Meili Sarr got the rebound. It's all counting for this card. He's doing wonders. Is he going to play it first time? He's not. Bender's there again. So honestly, there's a reason why people play fullbacks at centre back. They are just absolutely broken. Gundogan. I don't know what that mechanic is, but it's unlucky. Tried the finesse. He'd already moved his keeper to that side. It's unlucky. Right, last attack of the game for us. Where is he? It's Meili Sarr's made the run. Gundo. Can we get him an assist? We'll take an assist for him. Or can we actually get that last goal? Oh, he's just not got away in time. I'll take it. 4-2 win. Gundogan with the two goals and an assist. Whether he's got the rebound one, I do not know. We'll have a quick look. So 10 rating for Gundogan. Yeah, he was solid. 2 goals, 1 assist he got. I was very impressed by him. I didn't think I would. Cam, not as good as Mason Mount in my personal opinion. He felt more clunky. So I'll do another half with him at Cam, and then we'll move him to a box to box, see how he does there. But we'll get into game number two now and go from there. So next opponent is rocking a very sweaty squad. He's still got Varane. Obviously, if you're a viewer of the TikToks and the Twitch streams, you know we call him Varat. We got the Varat emote, so fingers crossed we can make him pay for still using 86 Varane at this stage of the game. Oh, Guerra's actually done something. Is he feeling all right? Oh, Gundogan's through. How's a chip? Oh, superb Gundogan. 1 minute into the game and he's already a lovely, dainty chip over the keeper. Well executed and made it 1-0. Good start for the lad. That's a lovely block from Gundo there. Oh my god. Has Gundogan just caused a rage quit here? He has. Oh my god. So two goals right off the bat for him. We're going to get into a third game because we need to keep using this card. So next opponent has got a 4-4-2 flat. Okay. Decent looking squad. Different. Some nice interesting players in there. Fingers crossed though. We can do some business here. We can do some damage. Do you know what I'm actually going to do? I really don't like this Aguero card. I'm taking him off straight off the bat because biggest regret SBC wise. Saying that. Watch him do something here. Oh, hello. Oh, oh my god. Gundogan. Oh, do I change my mind about him being a cam? I think I might, you know. He's actually doing an amazing job, especially with the engine chem style. He's feeling more agile this game. The very first game I played with him, he wasn't the best. I would say that. But so far, so good. I'm really enjoying this card. Really enjoying this card. All right, Gundogan, just stay on side, mate. Just stay on side. First time finesse. Oh, it's unlucky. Good pop shot. Good pop shot. Hopefully he's not quitting. No, just making the tactical change. Can Gundogan get into space? He has. He's opened up the finesse. Nick Pope has made a lovely save. Oh, Cuadrado has just managed to nick it away from him. Gundogan's there. Directional nutmeg. Oh, I don't know why he did the little skip. I just needed him to do an actual fake shot. Half time though. Half time. Obviously, Gundogan's goal with the difference maker in this half so far. Fairly equal game as well. Can go either way at the minute. We're going to make a sub. I'm going to bring on Vidal for Cantona. I just want an actual box-to-box mid there instead. Fingers crossed that works out for us. Can we get a little cheeky run from Gundogan there? Oh my god, if he scores this. Oh my god. I went silent because I was concentrating, but lovely hold-up play. Just look at him. Who was that? Is that Tavernier who was holding off? I think it might have been. Lovely hold-off play. Didn't let Tav get near him. Well composed with his dribbling, and he managed to slide home. Second goal. This Gundogan card's a lot better than people are making out to be, and his price should be a lot better than what it is. Yeah, I'm enjoying this card. We might have to try and fit him into the squad. He's dragged it way too wide there. Way too wide. I spoke too early because somehow he managed to get it back across goal. 2-1. We're still comfortable in this game, I feel. That's a lovely ball. Oh, Gundogan made a weird run. Trying to get past Cuadrado there. I thought we just got him through in time. How has he still got the ball? No. Oh, no. Oh, that is... We got lucky right there. We did get a dub, though. That is the main thing. Two goals for Gundogan. is what we love to see. Double look at his match rating, 9.1, so two goals there. Pass completed, 14 out of 18, was very nice. Dribbles completed, 18 out of 28, which is not too bad. Tackles won, 1 out of 2. Yeah, very solid card. Good opponent, very good opponent, fairly equal game. But we'll get back into the squad screen now. Joys of playing in Div 1, you get 500 points and you can redeem entry into Foot Champs like within 4 games. Yeah, we were on a par level-wise. Back over that 2,000 skill rating, which is something I like to see. So that has been it for this Gundogan player review. And I'm impressed by the card. As I said, I mean, I got 6 goals and an assist in 3 games with him from that cam spot. But ideally, I think he is going to work better as a box-to-box mid. He's got great defending stats, great physicality stats. His passing's great, his dribbling's good, and he can finish when you do push him for higher up the pitch. How much does he actually come in at? That's one thing I do actually want to check. He's about 100k. That's crazy. This card should not be 100k. But the market's dying at this sort of stage. I think he should be worth a lot more. I think if he had a tiny bit more pace, you might see a bigger increase in this card. You got to think, Mason Mount is very similar in stats, but Mount has the pace over this card, so that's what boosts its price so more. I would highly recommend picking him up. 100k, get him, try him out, see how he feels for you. I really enjoyed him. I might keep using him in squads going forward when we're doing more squad builders, especially with Bundesliga team of the season coming out soon. Obviously, he's got the German link there, so he'll feature in some of those squads. But that has been it for another episode. Thank you so much for your continued support on the channel. If you are new around here, make sure you smash that subscribe button and drop a like on this video. And until next time, peace out, YouTube.